Hey there, are you doing okay? My name is Robert. In this guitar lesson we're going to play a classic rock and roll song called Love Me Do from the British rock and roll formation The Beatles. That's why this dressed up outfit. Before we start with the lesson I want to say that we do have a website, Robert Rocks the Mandolin. There you can find playing charts, chords, written out solos, anything you need to help you with the songs you're playing during these video lessons. My wife creates all files on printable PDFs, so visit our website. Let's look at the song. There's an intro, verse, bridge, verse, solo, and a final verse. Let's start with the intro. Play it out for you first and then explain it. There we go. That's the intro. Sounds nice, doesn't it? Are we going to play that? Starting with the first line. G7 chord, 4 counts. Now we're getting C chord, 4 counts, and we're going to play that down, down, up, up, down. In this way. So one more time, the first line of the intro for you. Here we go, starting with the G7. Line number 2, played in exactly the same way, starting with G7. Line number 3, starting with the G7 chord again, here we go. C chord. And now we're getting a G chord, 2 times 4 counts. That's the intro, we're entering the first verse, play it out for you and then explain it, here we go. That's the first verse. Are we going to play that? Starting the first line. G chord, 4 counts. C chord, 4 counts, played in the same way as in the intro. Down, down, up, up, down. And this way. G chord again, 4 counts. C chord. G chord, 4 counts. C chord, 3 times 4 counts, plus 1. And the first part we're playing like the other C's. Down, down. Up, up, down. There we go. And now the other counts. And then muffle the sound at the end. So one more time, the first line for you. Here we go. Starting with the G chord. Second line of the first verse, G7, 4 counts, C chord, G chord, G7 chord again, excuse me, C chord. We're entering verse number 2, play it out for you and then explain it, here we go. That's verse number 2. I'm going to play that. First line is played in exactly the same way as the first line of the first verse. Here we go. G chord, 4 counts. C chord. G chord again. And now the long C. 3 times 4 counts plus 1. Here we go. And muffle at the end. Second line of the second verse, G7 chord, 4 counts, C chord, G7 chord again, 4 counts, now C chord, 1 downstrum, and now we're getting a riff, ring finger on the third position top string, middle finger, second position top string, open E string, and this way. So one more time, the second line of the second verse for you in a slow tempo. Here we go, starting with the G7. That's the second verse. We're entering the bridge. Play it out for you and then explain it. Here we go. That's the bridge part. Are we gonna play that? Starting with the D chord, 2x4 counts. Here we go. Now we're getting a C suspended 4 chord. Index finger, bar, the 2 bottom strings. Ring finger, 3rd position A string. And pinky, 3rd position D string. Please visit our website. On the site you can find all the chords you need to play this song. C suspended 4, 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. G chord 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. So one more time, the first line of the bridge for you. Here we go, starting with the D chord, 2x4 counts. Second line of the bridge, D chord again, 2x4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. C suspended 4. 4 counts. Now we're getting a G chord, 1 downstrum. F chord, 1 downstrum. And back to G chord, 1 downstrum. So one more time, the second line of the bridge for you. Here we go, starting with the D chord. That's the bridge. Heavy, isn't it? The final part, the quick changing of chords. We're entering verse number 3, and that's played in exactly the same way as the second verse. I'll play it out for you, why not? Then explain it. Here we go, starting verse number 3. That's verse number 3. Now we're gonna play that. First line, G chord, 4 counts. C chord, 4 counts. G chord again. C. Now the long C. Second line of the third verse, G7 chord, 4 counts. C chord. 4 counts, G chord, G7 chord, and now 1 downstrum on the C chord, and we're getting the riff, E3, E2, open, and now we're getting the harmonica solo part, we're doing the rhythm part, play it out for you and then explain it, here we go. That's the rhythm part of the solo. And we're gonna play that, starting in the first line, D chord, 2x4 counts. C suspended 4, 4 counts. G chord, 4 counts. Second line of the solo part, D chord, 2x4 counts. C suspended 4, 4 counts. And now we're getting a G chord. 4x4 counts plus 1. Here we go. And now we're getting the smash on the drums. And we're playing a D chord together with 1 downstrum. In this way. So one more time. The whole solo part for you. Here we go in a slow tempo. Starting with the D chord. Thank you. now we're getting verse number 4, the final verse. Play out for you and then explain it. Here we go. That's the final verse. How are we gonna play that? Starting the first line, G chord, 4 counts, C chord, 4 counts, G chord again, C, G. Now we're getting the long C, 3 times 4 counts plus 1. Line number 2, G7, 4 counts, G, 4, C. Line number 3, G7, 4 counts, C chord, 4 counts, G7 chord, C chord, G7 chord, 4 counts, and now we're getting the quick end, G, F, G, here we go. In this way, like we did in the bridge part the first time, so one more time. The final line for you, here we go, starting with the G7. That's the whole song Love Me Do explained. Tricky one to play, Beatles songs never are easy. So I hope you enjoyed the lesson, I hope to see you next time. Visit our website, Robert Dr. Mandolin. Take care, ciao, tschüss, arrivederci, buenas noches, dos vidania, hadu. Ah, there's Joost. Say hello to your friends, Joost.